One of the questions that every student who comes into this lab asks me is, if you guys have been doing this for 44 years, what questions still remain?
Oh my God, there's so many.
Every time you answer a question, you raise five more.
The more you study a system like this, the less you know about it.
Did you ever think that we would be sequencing the bird's genome?
No, I didn't know what the word genome meant in 1972. Just came in.
Hot silver dash hot.
Hot lime. That's not the bird we were missing, is it?
There's purple dash number orange.
Green lime silver dash. I know who that is.
This is a catchphrase for our overall project. We're studying the genomics of extinction. The idea is we're trying to understand what happens to the genetics of a population as it becomes so small in size and eventually goes extinct. The ultimate kind of 10-year plan is to use the scrub jays as a model system for trying to understand what happens when population sizes become really small. Oh, I just heard wings. Here we go. I study population genomics, but I would call myself an evolutionary biologist first and then an ornithologist second. Are you gonna come? See, I finally learned how to hold on to peanuts. Took several years. In middle school, I wanted to be a field biologist, mostly because I loved animals and wanted to work with animals. I didn't really develop an interest in birds until high school. And even then, I had no idea that I would be doing this. I want one on my head. What we're doing right now is collecting blood. These samples form the whole basis of my project. Without the DNA samples, I would have nothing to analyze. The beauty of the Florida scrub jay is it's been studied for so long. There's 40 years worth of data. We know everything about every bird. We know when it was born, how many offspring it had, how many offspring their offspring had. We have measures of habitat quality, territory size. There's so much data. And so my goal is that if we add on genomics for all of these birds for which we have complete life histories, then we can actually start to ask a bunch of questions that no one else was able to ask before. It's pretty exciting. Somebody asked me the other day, oh, there we go. So our goal for the next couple years is to really truly understand what is going on with these birds. Can we identify genes in this bird on my head that can help explain how long he's going to survive and how many nestlings that he produces over his lifetime? I mean, this is kind of one of the most fundamental questions in evolutionary biology. What is the genetic basis for fitness? Why do some individuals do better than others? We don't know, and our goal is to use all the information we have with these birds to try to answer that.
Purple, purple,
and purple, purple orange. Got it. The joy of discovering something new. There really isn't something that comes close to that. Discoveries don't come often, but that's okay, because when it does happen, when you find a new result, it's really exciting. So we're missing the female and purple lime. When I decided to go to grad school, I wanted to do some combination of lab work and field work. And it turns out now I spend probably 70% of my time in front of a computer programming. That was a bit of a surprise. It's good for me to come reacquaint myself with the birds, get re-excited about the biology. Plus, I just love it here. There's no other place like this on Earth. If you want to understand what are the genes that influence survival and reproduction, I'm not going to be able to measure that in the lab. Ow, that actually hurts.